to begin. Hello, friends. How are you all today? Wait and you see the first match that has been thrown at us. I'll go Mute City for this one, I think. How's everyone today? You all doing well? I hope so. Ah, I'm okay. I was going to do this yesterday, but I was too tired. Far too tired. So it's happening tonight instead. And, well, look at this opening match. Look at it. Look at it. Look at it. Fatigue is the worst. But, we're going to sit here and have some fun tonight, right? So two competitors who came up just ever so short in the C64 Summit, getting a chance at this lovely title. The rules of which are simple. It will be defended in every single Fire Pro stream we do. What an opening match we have. Two strong girls. Hello, Morrigan. So here we go. Who's your money on? Proverbial. Because it's kind of hard to separate these two. Yeah. Although you could separate them like that by hurling one of them out of the ring. Yeah. Oh, hello, Mookie. My cat has come to say hello. Hey, you. How are you up to? Oh, sliding D there from Catwell. Leg trip takedown, gets caught, punches to the head. New referee Kat Labash straight in there. Oh, scoop slams are out of the ring again. Kat Labash. I did say, I think I said that last time, like the whole thing was she was going to be a medic backstage, and the closest way we can do that is just make her a ref. Yeah. Plus, it's a referee we know won't take any shit. The former competitor herself. Back in the 2K days was the Wild at Heart champion. Formerly the FTR championship. And yes, we used it first. Exactly, Spike Dragon. Very evenly fought so far. Oh, there's stunting on her with the cover. It's the ropes full speed ahead for the Superman punch. Catwheel just stood straight up, but does not stand straight up from the backbreaker. Flash further, trying to wear down her opponent. Again with the takedown. But she is not getting much done on the mat. Gets caught every time. Catwell into the corner, back elbow. Follows up with Dirty Deeds, done dirt cheese. Bella heading up top, thinks better of it. Misses with the lariat. Winds up though. Oh, but she's out of breath. And could this be where Buff Catwell, I beg your pardon, moves in for the kill? Hangs her up in the tree of Joey Lawrence. For no good reason. Hell of a suplex there. Oh, there's that gutbuster. Oh, but she's just blown up. Crossroads just again with the cockiness. Oh, and there's the spear, and this could be just be buffs to win. So am I, Jim. This was not supposed to happen. Well, I guess that's what happens when you go so hard all day, all night. Taking no time to recuperate. Oh, coming back with a flurry though. Back in the corner, spear of her own. 2.9, so very close. Emerald Flosion! And Buff Catwell with the Flosion gets the job done. Hell of an opening contest. What have we got next? Because I did completely rando these. Some interesting matches coming up. Such as this one. time limits on these round one matches. There he is, with brand spanking new music. Glory days, man. 2006. Original blue named Denim Dresscoat. JBI has a tough ask ahead of him. How's the glory days? Because I was like that, man. Just strutting about my denim jacket on, man. Yeah, this is a tough ask indeed for JBI. Destroyer, who was actually defeated by Mirabella in a huge upset to try and qualify for the C64 Summit group stage. But no stranger to winning tournaments herself. Anytime we have done an elimination round tournament that Destroyer has been in, they've made it to the finals. And in one case of the Bofa 19 tournament, won the thing. Also, why is it so hot? Why is it so hot? Bloody roasted. And it's JBI that goes down from the strike exchange. Somebody asks the sun what gives. Mother Nature does hate us. Yeah. Like, I'm sat here in a t-shirt and boxers, because this is a sexy stream, and I'm still roasting. Big slap. Oh, must have just grazed him. Because ordinarily that spinning backfist can spell the end of a match. We do not speak dragon because this is Scotland. You know, houses don't generally have air conditioning here. Because most of the time, houses here don't need them, you know, because it's generally a pretty cold country. And, like, chances are those of you that stay in the US, especially obviously the southern states, I mean, that's a fair point, Spike Dragon. But yeah, it's not as common here as it is elsewhere. I mean, those of you that say it in, like, maybe like the southern US or whatever, would probably experience the heat here and go, what's the big deal? I can tell you, it's very different. Like, the humidity is different. He's like, I can take the heat in the southern US. I can take the heat in, like, Spain. But see the heat in Scotland, at least. It's very different. Florida as well, Morgan. I've been to Florida, and I could take the heat there just fine. But it's a different kind of heat. And already we've got the weapons out. Oh God, Brainbuster on the floor. Destroyer's got wood. Oh, JBI back up. He's not done yet. Brainbuster onto the knee. Goes for the cover. Destroyer out at two. He was going for it again. D reverses with the suplex. How? Well, it must have been all those weapon shots on the outside. This should be a strange match. There's going to be someone I don't think yous have seen much of. So, fresh from having a pretty decent finish overall, considering the start he had to the C64 Summit, JJ Strife. Oh no, I didn't move her there. Oh no, she's in Europa Star Pro, that's right. Going up against Cara De Pato. Because I forgot to put the count outs back on. Which one's Christy? I don't play much Tekken. I think the last Tekken I played was the third one. Although I played one of the like the tag team ones on an arcade. Capo. Oh right, okay. Now this is Cara De Pato. Rumour has it she's a famous Instagram model under that mask, but will not reveal her identity. Fight. Obviously outmatched as far as power goes in this match. I can't remember if I ever played 4. Like, I might have played it once or twice, but like not a lot. I read the paddle with the big face buster there. Has to use her speed here. Also, if I can drop the character for a second. If you Google what Cara De Pato is in Spanish, you'll get the Instagram model joke. Another scoop slam from Cara De Pato. Still trying to use her speed. been able to hold her ground so far. Oh god, big frog splash off the top from JJ Strike. Oh, here we go. Trading. Weird Snoop Dogg thing. Oh, fall away slam. And she's doing her all. Try and keep up with the power of JJ Strife, but every one of those big and high-packed moves takes more and more out of her. Oh, low drop kick. Buying herself some time to recover. Oh, went for the run, I got caught. And just barely was able to get the shoulder up. Oh, catches it ran on that time. Only one. Needs to really do more damage to Strife. Needs to start utilizing that speed, that agility. Rana again. Kicks the leg out of the leg. Oh, Jaguar defense again. Big axe kick. I didn't see, I played Gran Turismo 3 and I didn't know that. I was more interested in the feeder and Grand Theft Audio songs though. Sky Twister moonsault. Nearly got him. Oh, big splash in the corner. She gets to go by. Face Buster. Alright, okay. Oh no! Master Sword drags her away from the ropes just like that. It could be over. But she is still in it. And Strife is firing up. Jaguar defense again. Sky Twister. Oh, was, looked like she was perhaps thinking of the back whacker. And ironically, that song is as good as it gets, because that song is an absolute beezer. I think the our version had Wake Up on it as well, and I want to say Dead Man Leaving. Oh god! Rolls through into the submission. Wake Up and Dead Man Leaving are. The entire Grand Theft Audio album is full of bangers. In fact, fun fact, Spike Dragon. Remember that tune that Becky Lynch briefly had in NXT? The Anything You Wanna Do! That was them as well. Oh, I love As Good As It Gets. It's such a good song. Like, the non-album version is even better. there was like a different mix of it, where it was essentially the same song, but it had like a different lead guitar line, and it's actually even better. Yeah, like what happened, Jim, was the basically Grand Theft Audio only ever had the one album. They were in the middle of doing their second one, where when they got dropped by their label and ended up splitting up. So they took a lot of the songs that they had and just kind of reworked them slightly and sold them off as like stock music for TV and stuff. And NXT ended up using one of them for Becky Lynch's theme for a while. Yeah, I didn't even know, because I got that, I found that song, Spike Dragon, like before the album came out in the UK anyway. I think it was like a bonus track on some of the vinyl versions of the album or something. And I found it, you know, not, by the way, not on Napster. Does anyone remember Audio Galaxy? I found it on there. And it wasn't until like I bought the album when it came out here that I even realised there was a different mix of it. She got him! Hell of a match. Yeah, great debut. I mean, I think I've used her on some of the sort of cam streams. Like the chill streams I've done through the night sometimes and stuff like that, which I don't think ever get archived. But that was her first proper debut. So, next up will be Calypso Sage. Going up against Luna Rose. She did duck him. I like it. So out of all the Sideburns Worldwide members who competed in the C64 Summit, Calypso Sage actually performed the best, even outperforming Mark Anzoni. Hell of an accomplishment. Going up against Luna Rose. Fell short in the qualifiers. And part of the roster of our new all-women's promotion, Women's Action Pro. Taking it pretty back and forth, this one. Watch as I jinx it and someone gets criticaled in like 3 minutes or something. Big slappy. Oh, DDT already. Sage so far taking it to Rose. And as we've seen Lunar Rose can sometimes take a little while to get going, but highly skilled competitor. Elevated Texas Cloverleaf there. They are not Spike Dragon. It's all a coinky dink. Oh, big high Enziguri there. Beautiful swinging neckbreaker. Rose hits the ropes for a sliding lariat. Yeah. Sasha Rose, incidentally, will be in action in this tournament. Working the leg. Hazard in the corner, just ramming into the gut, trying to knock the wind out of her. Oh, covered attempt off the kick out. You bloody weirdo. Jeebus effect there from Sage. Now trying to work the leg. Sweeps out the leg. Oh, sliding lariat again, cover. Oh my, could it be? Oh, that could be. Apocalypso hit quite early. Rose managed to kick out. Takes a brain buster though. And Rose could, oh, I was about to say Rose could be in trouble, but manages to lock in a crossface. See, managing to hold it on. Took a bit out of her though. Sweeps out the leg, drop kick in the corner, beautifully done. Oh, that beautiful straight combination. Firing up now to take a fisherman neck breaker. Managed to roll through into the cover, nothing doing. Sage continues to work on her. Oh, the girl sent on to the small of the back, follows it with a leg drop off the top. Beautiful drop kick. Now Rose hits the rope sliding lariat. And now, neither of them giving an inch. Super kick. Oh, the spinning backhand as well. Great combination leads to a big drop kick. Almost sent her careening out of the ring. Oh, what's she going for here? Hits the ropes. Sliding German. Left too long though. Allowed Sage that small bit of time to recuperate. Manages to lock in a cover though. Sent into the corner. Calypso Sage planting her up top. Oh god! Canadian Destroyer off the top does not do it. Because what's psychology anyway, right? Rose recover. Lunar Rose advances. So we've had some damn fine matches so far. What have we got next? Ooh. It'll be a little jumble. Run against the great Mellotron, who unlucky to not make the C64 summit as a result of being injured. So yeah, Mellotron was unlucky to not make the C64 Summit Group stage, was injured by one Frillhole. You get to see here how Mellotron has recuperated from that injury. Not two, not three, but one Frillho, and one is the loneliest number. And it left Mellotron very lonely at home while her partner Sasha Rose was away competing in the C64 Summit. Here we go. Mellotron the more experienced of the two, but Lulu Jambo has been showing some fine performances, hasn't been able to win any of those Battle Royal Winner's Choice challenges, but has performed very, very well in some of them. Slice through the legs. Oh god, knees to the head there. Jambo managed to slide out. The cover was way too close to the ropes. Use those fives to wear down Melvana. Oh, got caught. Oh, dropped on the knees. And who do you have here, folks? Because it's been pretty back and forth so far. Oh, big axe kick. Low blow. Big headbutt from Melvana. Jambo fighting back with all she has. Melvana off the ropes. Oh god, what a high knee. High knee. Big high knee again. Jambo continuing to target those knees. Low blow! Into the cover! And take a deep breath before getting ripped in the eyes! Oh shit, Mel has had enough. Pump handle bomb into a frog splash, but too close to the ropes. Oh, big Rana there. Jambo, monkey flip right on the face. Put some momentum on that, drops on the knees. Having her head repeatedly rammed into that steel turnbuckle pad. Why did we think that was a good idea anyway? Look, cheeks to face. Followed by a giant swing. Cocky cover, but still got a two count off it. Blocked out the suplex there. And nearly got the job done. Misses with the enziguri. Death Valley driver. Into the paradise lock. Melly does not tap. And now just teeing off on each other's faces. Super kick. Oh, but there is a typical Scottish headbutt there. Go behind. Oh, got caught by the kick. And every bit of momentum that gets built, the other one does something to try and undo it. Gets the win with a paradise lock. Is that a first? Damn fine match, though. What are we going next? One second, folks. How's everyone doing anyway? You all doing well? You all doing good? It's all of it. I'm just roasting. It's absolutely roasting. I was just trying to put out a few matches done so far kind of tweet, and the tags weren't working. Alright. So next up, Sous Chef versus. Joanna's all excited because there's thunder and that outside. Sous Chef versus Rabbit. I hope so too, Spike Dragon. Rabid looking to turn things around after an underwhelming performance in the C64 Summit. Certainly turmoil within the dark room right now. The bastard Denton costing Charlie Webb the chance of being the finalist from Block B. All is not well. Kicked him in the bum. Both similar styles, both kind of hard hitting, rough and tumble, not afraid to use weapons. Snap suplex from Rabbit. Oh, dropped him on. Knackers first on the knee. Now just trying to choke the life out of him. Elbow back of the head. Turnabout fair play. Taz, my balls! Oh, dropped him. Hello, Rabbit. Oh. Oh, dropped him again. Big lariat, but Rabbit just stood straight back up. Fires in with some elbow shots of his own. Oh, hooks her up. Red Eye Virus. He's taking a bit of damage. Wasn't able to capitalize with the cover immediately. God, Scoop slammed him out of the ring. Rabbit grabs a light tube. Crowd booing the sous chef. Oh, they're behind Rabbit. Listen to that. Now Rabbit hits the ropes. Boo chef, I got him. No coming back from a burn like that. No matter how well protected you are in that kitchen. Go behind. Reverse suplex. And now trading again. Rabbit fires up, headbutt. Oh, but turns out they both got hard heads, and who knew? Red Eye Virus. Leg is hooked, cover. Now just trying to choke him. Rabbit fakes his way out. Rabbit up top, flies in with the elbow. Now driven across the knee. Oh, Rabbit, perhaps looking for the animal trap there. Sasha Rose has not fought yet, Afi, but you are through. Oh, missed with the fire. Rabbit missed with the sweet volley high. But does not miss. With the Red Eye Virus driving. The sous chef head first into the mat. Rabbit is through to the next round. The first man to make it through to the next round. Next up, we have two competitors who were both in action during the C64 summit, but were in opposite groups. No, you change. What a match this should be. Sam King might be the ace of TCW. Going against the toughest bitch alive, Connie Bomier. As always, praising the sun before she makes it into the ring. Expect a hard-hitting one here. And obviously the power, the physical strength advantage has to go to Sam King. But he's not the toughest bitch alive. As anyone who watched the BOFA 19 tournament will remember that 90 minute test of endurance between Connie Bomier and Buck Lincoln. Yeah. Sam King hates leg day, hates cardio. If you hear rumbling in the background, that's all it is, by the way. It's just thunder outside. Just giving a slam and now just laying in with the fists on the mat. Oh god, big super. Oh, what a pervert! Did you see that with that cover? Jeebus effect from Connie. Locks in the chancery. Oh, she bust him open. You can even see his blood at the top of that shirt dripping down the chest of Sam King. Misses with a drop kick. Big suplexo takes her to the outside. Now they're going to fight on the outside. It does a little bit, but it's not great, Jim. Elbow at the back of the head. STF on the floor. Hurts more because it's on the floor. That rhymes, margin. You know it rhymes. Admit it. Sam King has a chair. She just stood there and took it. Shot in the gut. Connie heads up top. Hello, Rockford. This is Connie Bomier versus Sam King. Oh god, referee down. And Connie with the victory roll. She could have had him. Swinging neck breaker under the chair. Oh god, what is he doing? Orange crush. She is a medic. Tombstone on the chair. And they're firing in with those headbutts. See, she loves those knees. Big backbreaker from Sam King though, who is continuing to leak blood. Gets the frog splash. Cover! Brainbuster! Oh god, the Tiger Driver! The Tiger Driver! But she just brain busters him. Vicious chop to that beefy chest. Oh god! Left hand drops her. Versus Irish Whip. Oh, drop kick. You see the blood continuing to leak out of the head. It is a war of attrition. Connie Bummie does not know any other way to wrestle, if we're quite honest. Discus and gravy to the back of the head. Follows with the ripcord knee. And Ella Mastral. And now they trade. Discus and gravy again. Turnabout fair play. Hits the brainbuster. But the blood loss. He's exhausted. He can't capitalize. Oh god, huge belly to belly sends her to the outside, and now he's taking a step back to try and recuperate, try and catch his breath. Another very pro move. But she gets him up for the tombstone. So very nearly got it done. Destino! But she got him too quick, so puts her back down with the discus and gravy. More headbutts. King's Landing! And he gets it! Hell of a match. And we're not going to waste any time. We've got quite a few matches to get through. Next up, fresh from a successful debut the other night, Jarriff Harper. Going up against John Robertson. Jarrett Harper had a damn fine showing in that tryout match. Going up against John Robertson. We'd like to thank our crack ring crew for getting the ring cleaned up in time for this match. And by crack ring crew, I mean we feed them crack. It makes them work quicker. We still don't know that much about Jarrett Harper yet. Whereas John Robertson, a big cheating bastard, or a wee cheating bastard, depending on your perspective of scale.
Finish!
Missed that flying Kakeshi there. Ain't a bat hanging stretch. Shades of a referee. Former competitor Battle Clash, now senior official Kat Labash. La Mahistral came too close to the ropes. Airplane spin from Robertson. Jaguar defense though into the submission. Oh, now they're trading. But Jarrett had the smart idea, going for the midsection, trying to drive the wind out of his opponent. Oh, locks in the Rings of Saturn. Oh, he's going for the airplane spin again. Instead, sends Harper into the turnbuckle. Big boom of lightning in the background there. One count. Also, hello, Gojira. Has anyone ever given up to an airplane spin? Oh, kicks the leg out of the leg. And a rolling senton with those spikes on the shoulder pads. I've touched those things, they're bloody sharp. No, but I've seen someone get knocked out by a giant swing. Brutal DDT from Harper. Oh, rolls through into an intricate cover. Goes for the cover again. Almost a Gato clutch. Super kick from John. John catches a jawbreaker. Up top leg drop. Lock up again. Oh God. Thank you. John Robertson getting caught. Those attacks to the shoulder again. Both had similar ideas, both missed. Harper with the go-behind gets a low blow. Sends Robertson into the corner. Hits the ropes. I'm half tempted to agree, Ambler. Also, hello, welcome. But does not give up. Robertson with the headbutt. Now they're taking this fight to the outside. Only to go right back in again. Back hanging stretch. Implemented it too close to the rope. Small package. Backslide. Determined to try and put Robertson away. Now that Harper knows what he's dealing with. Someone unafraid to cheat. Lamahistral again. And the crowd coming alive for this one. Harper up top, big boy sent on. Liked it so much he went up for another. Ripcord knee. Robertson with a low blow. Rolling senton with those spikes again. And another move that was so nice it got done twice. Bat hanging stretch again. Robertson taps. Jarif Harper goes through. Next up will be page B. The sideburns were wide. Accompanied by Eddie Sideburns. Going up against Laguna Suerte. Who have you got, chat? Page, another former Wild at Heart champion from back in the 2K days. Quite a few Spike Dragon Calypso Sage and Scott Murren, as they're all members of Sideburns Worldwide. So Paige with that rough technical hybrid style. Mosqueda tends to more utilise speed, high flying manoeuvres. Eddie just sliding epic weapons into the ring every chance he gets. Slides in with a drop kick. Page go behind, gets caught with the Jaguar defense. Sliding drop kick again. Oh, kicks the leg out of the leg. Beautifully done. Yeah, it's very much a where did they get these wonderful toys situation. Oh, missed with the Jeebus effect. You can see Sideburns looking on. Hello, Laguna! You're really having a rummage in there, aren't you, Darren? Oh, beautifully done. Yeah. Oh, Tiger Driver. Two kick. We're going to send her into the ropes. Beautiful arm drag. Oh, absolutely, Morrigan. Beautiful Rana. Suerte looking interested. Up against Page B of Sideburns Worldwide. Beautiful. Sweet volley high. Cover. Goes for into the cover. Oh, stiff forearm there. Destino though. They're just trading big moves at the moment. Facebuster. Suerte up top. Perched. Prepared. Dives off with the DDT. Beautifully done. Paige still fighting back though. Goes up top herself. Diving headbutt. Rolls through. Cover. Too close to the ropes though. Oh. Sends Suerte into the ropes again. Jeebus effect. Now train. Spinning backhand, but Enziguri to immediately follow up from Suerte. Oh, diving knee to the back. Suerte back up. Oh god, what an elbow. Suerte is still in the fight though. Considering what to do next instead, elects to stand back, catch their breath, a smart move. You fool! Diving headbutt! Swear to you though, Destino! Hits the ropes, misses with a sweet volley high. But not with the Destino. These two are just kicking each other's asses at the moment. Diving leg drop back of the head. Swear to you though, that kangaroo kick goes for the cover, but Sideburns is up on the apron distracting the referee. What's happening here? Swerty gets back in the ring. Destino! You see him now cowering after Cat Labash gave him a piece of her mind. Two count. Michinoku driver. Oh God, heroes welcome. And just when we thought we were getting somewhere, the old tactics of Sideburns Worldwide start to resurface. What have we got next? Ooh. Next one is a very interesting one. Yep, the Sideburns were at it again. Next up, former Pier 6 champion, the Big Chef. Going up against Daniel Fulhard. And, oh yeah, in case anyone missed it, there is our new women's company. Women's Action Pro, WAP. Look out for stuff coming from them very soon. So hello everyone. Just to do my wee plug thing, we are 15 followers away from 1,000. Strife was in the tournament, Rabbit. Strife got caught by Cara De Pato. Yeah, 15 followers away from 1,000, 9 subscribers away from a new emote slot, and we've already got plenty of swanky emotes that you can use if you do subscribe. All of the money from subscriptions and whatnot at the moment. And there he is, right as I say it. All of the money from subscriptions and whatnot at the moment. Basically going towards my next payout will be to get a capture card, as I have plenty of old wrestling games for like the PS1 and PS2 that I'd love to stream sometime. And it basically just would give me more options. And I don't think that puts the... Yeah, it didn't put the like the subscriber points thing. Use it for an air conditioner. In this temperature, very probably. But yeah, that one didn't go out because that was Leo renewing his subscription, but nonetheless grateful. I'm grateful when anyone does it. anyone would spend money on my dumb shit, you know what I mean? What ones? Basically, I've got all the SmackDown ones. I've got, like, Warzone, Attitude, I've got both the ECW ones, I've got a lot of the, like, the WCW ones, you know, like, Versus the World and stuff like that. I've also got the AAA game for the PS3. I also have a physical copy of Fire Pro Wrestling Returns for the PS2. So for those just coming in, this is a tournament for a new championship, the Twitch.tv Championship, and the idea is you have Raw versus SmackDown. Yes, Laguna, I do. Mm. I would love to at some point as well get another working N64, because I do have the games for that, just not an N64, as it was, like, way back when I lived with, like, my parents. It was my sister that had the N64. Fun thing, Jim, there was DLC for it, which you can't get anymore, but one of the DLC guys for it was actually Mark Jindrak. Did lose the Pier 6 title, yes. Alas, so. Our current Pier 6 champion is Cynthia, an undead monster woman thing. Because of course! I still have my copy of the Scott Pilgrim game on my PS3 as well, so I could maybe stream that at some point. Face slam. We've seen him beat opponents with that and very nearly got Danny Foolhardy with it there. Now a big trade off centre of the ring. Super kick from Foolhardy. Goes for the cover and Big Chef is having none of that shit. From Foolhardy. I mean, Foolhardy is a tough competitor, but he, as far as strength goes, he's very much outmatched here. Having to use his smarts, his agility, his speed. Oh, Pele kick, and he's just stood straight back up. Reverse suplex. And there's that speed we were talking about. Tried to drag him away from the ropes. Oh, brief fire at him. Finley rope. Joe Hardy takes it to the leg. Rolls through cover. There's the Pelly kick there. Sends him into the ropes. Tilt a world slam. Having to think about what to do next instead. Ops for that face slam again. What kind of dish is the big chef going to be serving here? I mean, at the moment, I think he's just out for vengeance on the world after losing that Pier 6 championship. And vengeance, of course, much like gazpacho soup, is a dish best served cold. Oh yes, our new sponsor, Gay Burger. Home of the Gay Burger. Can I take your order? What would you like between your buns today? It's Gay Burger. What does it taste like? Chicken. Cover off the Emerald Fusion. They're both into the ropes. Oh God, just volleyed him straight in the face there. And there we have it. The Big Chef advances. His lady woman, the sous chef, might not have been so lucky, sadly falling short to Rabid, but the big chef ensuring at least one member of the Curry House Fight Club will advance. Oh, Pack and Blee's here as well. Pack and Blee, another second round boy. They do, Spike Dragon, the cathedral cover of it. Next up, oh, this is going to be a bloody strange one. The tournament is going well. We're just doing the first round today. The idea is just to keep going. We're going to do the finals at Summer Blockbuster on the 23rd. The people who have advanced so far: Buff Catwell, Destroyer, Cara DePato, Luna Rose, Lulu Jambo, Rabid, Sam King, Jareth Harper, Paige B, and now the Big Chef. And now it is the turn of Forever Craig. Time for the You Bastards, all of the You Bastards. Going up against Mandy Mayhem, who was a two-time Ironman back in the 2K days. But she is up against a very important and very tall man right here. Spinning backhand. Craig! Thank you for the resub, Craig. You lovely, lovely man. Oh, You're very lovely, very important, and very tall man.
You bastard.
You bastard. Manages to take him over there, but oh god, big super kick there from Craig. Sits on her head for a one count. He's looking for big moves already. Lovely, important, and tall. That does mean you are lit. Dragon screw leg, what? Big slappy. Locks in that cravat again. Now they're trading. She's smacking them titties, but it's not enough. Head kickison. Sometimes even I don't know what I'm saying. Sends him into the ropes. Oh, he blocks his spinning backhand. But does not block that high-speed knee. Head Kickerson could be a person. Maybe that's going to be my next MMA guy.
You bastard. You bastard.
Missed with the cutter again. She stamps on the eyes. The eyes! That could be it, Spike Dragon. That's a good idea. But then it would be like Head Kickovich. Which I'm not mad at. Dragon screw leg whip forever. Craig with the big boy sent on. I still need to add the Beverly Brothers to it too, like the Regime version, because it kept playing their theme that on those streams. Delicious cover there. Right hand green. You know, in the 2K. Back in the 2K days when we did my big birthday bash, I actually did make a Twister mat for the ring. Hits the Twister Craig. Followed by the Bracket Buster. And a camel clutch. Fisherman Neck Craigor. These two are kicking each other's asses. Oh, twist the Craig! Sits on the head for the cover. Down there! Hooks him up for the cover. 2.9. The Craig Runner!
You bastard!
Super Craig! I don't know if that's what he calls them, but this is what I'm calling them. Get some of the Rana off the top. Now just smacking them titties. Some places you would have to pay for that. Big standy boy!
You bastard.
Craig drops her with a jab. Into the Boston Craig. Top rope Rana again. Oh, he's backing this up. Elbow, and he takes a bow. Cross arm Krieger. It does sound like a heavy metal band mascot, actually. Oh, big lariat there. Top rope Craigton. I mean, Iron Maiden, they've got Eddie. Lots of rumbling in the background. Lots of thunder out there. That's pretty cool. Oh, planting them up top again. Top rope Rana again. Now she goes up herself. Waiting on him standing up. Flying drop kick. Dead in air. Hooking him up for the cover. So very nearly got the job done. Flying elbow. Back up top for more. Eat shit on that attempt. Now Craig's back up. Hits the ropes. Caught the right forearm, gets dropped with the chop. That rounds Mars, you know it rounds a minute. Super Craig. Forever Craig advances. Next up, the Allen Road of Sideburns Worldwide. Going up against Kingpin Jim. The soupy kick, I like that. I think it works. Wait a minute, I'm receiving word. Due to his hatred of Sideburns Worldwide, Jordan Casanova will be accompanying Kingpin Jim to the ring for this one. To try and even up the odds, so to speak. I'll make him learn, Jim. And here comes Kingpin Jim. Who have you got, folks? This absolute sex demon. Misses with the lariat, but keeps running for his own amusement more than anything else. And we know Alan Rogue loves to try and work the limbs. Another technical bruiser. Back in the 2K days, he was one half of the longest reigning simultaneous champions. Held those titles along with Mark Anzoni for a very impressive 11 months. Eddie already sliding things into the ring like a bad egg. I mean, the power edge definitely going to Kingpin here. Big Uranage! Aurora Borealis this time of year only gets a one count. Sweeps him over with the lowercase AA. Continuing to work the limbs. Oh, here we go, a trade-off. The Cyburns continues to slide more weapons into the ring. Takes out the leg. I've just noticed we've been going for almost 2 hours already, and God, it doesn't feel like it, does it? Sends Rogue into the ropes, big forearm. Beautiful cover. Oh, ran into each other like a pair of fools. Romero stretched there from Rogue. Kingpin looks pissed. Delicious cover. Oh, reverses it. Snap suplex into that steel turnbuckle pad. Rogue suplexes him to the outside. Oh, Cyburns try to get involved. Hits him with his own, or his old one move. That was Mr. Rogue's Wild Ride Mark 1. Of course, he uses Mark II as a finisher now. Aurora Borealis of his own. Beautiful roly-poly in the corner. Pete Shetland the diving knee attempt. Continuing to hone in on the extremities of him though. Spinning Brain Buster. Follows it with a huge Uranagi. Bump to the face. Road sent in again. Big slap. Beautiful cover. Suplex. Big forearm and elbow. Very tightly fought contest so far. And that was Mr. Rogue's Wild Ride Mark II, but too close to the ropes. Rogue up top, catches the knees this time. Delicious cover, but too close to the ropes. Blocks the suplex, hits one of his own. I love it forever, Craig. I want someone to make an avalanche overdrive as well. I believe I suggested that, like, Amy Alonzi start using one during the... What's up? That's good. Moki, maybe? Weird. And he's got the cover, but Sideburn's distracting the referee again. Big Uranagi. Lariat. Smacked at the back of the head. They try to choke Rogue out, but he's too close to the ropes. I would love it if they did a big you're out of here thing. That would be amazing. Hits the ropes, big lariat. Follows with a huge Uranagi. Rogue trying desperately to fight his way back into this. Kicking the bum. Hits the ropes on his own. Oh, dodges lariat. Jim sent into the corner. Repeated titty smacks. La Magistral too close to the ropes. Roll up. Alan Rogue doesn't know how ropes work. Jim Jam.
Okay, baby.
But Sideburns again distracting the ref. Mr. the double axe handle after all that. Aurora Borealis! Well, at least he got a one. Brainbuster! cheeks to the face. Oh, huge rolling slap there. Cover. Get some. And that's 100 for a match with 2 seconds, which never bloody happens. Next up. Vera Forrest. Versus Eddie Violet. One of the critical club lock, Spike Dragon. So here we go. Oh, there he is. Two different stories here. Eddie Violet still trying to recapture that form that led to him becoming the first grand champion we had here in the Fire Pro era. Whereas Vera Forrest is still very much looking to make a name for themselves. Powerbomb. And again. Oh, roly-poly sent on. Puts it across face. Forrest fights her way out. Reverses the Irish whip, big lariat there. Beautiful flying head scissors followed by the roly-poly senton. Run into each other like a pair of fools. Oh, trying to confuse Forrest there. Forrest just fired away with the elbows. Oh, good grief, a pop-up powerbomb. And very nearly made this one a short one. Oh, go behind into here. Victory roll, too close to the ropes. Inzaghi, small package. Violet realizing the strength that he's up against. And is likewise trying to put a quick finish to this one. Big solid lariat in the corner. Missed with the pay dirt attempt. Sends Forrest into the ropes. Blocks the soul, but another attempt. Hurricane Rana, one count. Fuckbuster. Looking for the destroyer there. Forrest blocks it. Lariat followed by the rolling knee. Gets the destroyer this time. Cover. Big stompy. Now seeing that fighting spirit that Violet has come to be known for. Oh god, big brain buster there. Two. 2.9, so very, very close. Jaguar defense though. Water wheel drop. But Forrest is up first. Destroyer again. Cover! And now they're trading. Now they're trading. Spinning backhand. Super kick. Hoist it up. Gutbuster. Forrest. Now off the ropes. Go behind. Fuckbuster. Rolling Swanton there. Followed by the Poison Rana. Forrest back up. Dominair! Destroyer again! Forrest with the win. Oh, can you hear the thunder then, can you? Can you hear the rumble? Next up will be the debut. Of Dragon Spike. Going up against Lord and Order, who will be accompanied by, of course, Bikini Inspector Grobbelaar. I don't know what will be going on with it this weekend, but it'll be a lot of fun. I'm definitely looking forward to it. Obviously, I won't be streaming on Saturday because I don't want to go up against that. By the way, Spike, I forgot to set the entrance stuff, but apart from that, it's all good to go. There is Spike Dragon making his debut against Lord and Order of the Thought Police. He's like the captain, basically. Well, not the captain, that's a different rank, but... like the manager of the Thought Police. If you want the real explanation, there was a character in Bottom once called Inspector Grobbelaar. And I thought of the name Bikini Inspector Grobbelaar, couldn't stop giggling, and decided to make it so. A very definite clash of styles here. Hell yeah. Repeated headbutts there from Lord and Order. Oh god! And shoot style knees from Spike Dragon. That's an interesting way for him to make his debut, because how clearly, as you can see, more suited to the shoot style perhaps. The Rootin' Tootin' division for that Pew Pew Championship. But interesting to see how he goes up against professional wrestlers. Goes for the try to take him downtown. And you know, Dragon Spike trying to show how it's done. Cover mid. Take down and the side headlock. Tries to go by. Oh, try to take him downtown again. Jawbreaker and a headbutt. Dragon Spike though with the takedown. Law and Order fights her way out. He catches the heel hook. Law and Order scrambled to the ropes, made it. Eat defeat. Single leg Boston Crab. Probably the most professional wrestling style move. I mean, I would give that to all of the Thought Police, Jim. Oh, rolls through, knee bar. Go ahead, take down. Law and Order slides her way out. Oh, just a vicious elbow to the back of the head there. Hits the ropes. Oh god. Kick to the ribs. Cross arm breaker. Law and Order still going though. Oh god, vicious strike combo there. And a single leg Boston Crab again. Slowly destroying the limbs of Law and Order, who's fighting back with those headbutts. She's heading up top. Flies off with the lariat. Cover is made. Oh, big shoot knee to the midsection there. Slides out again. Cover! Spit Dragon gets out. Locks in the submission again. Bikini and Spectre Grobber are looking on. Takedown. Oh god! Just vicious ground and pound there. Doing real damage. Rolls through into the knee bar again. Slides out from the back mount again. Oh god, the brass knucks! Using that contraband to try and take out her opponent. Key lock put in, but too close to the ropes. Gets the win! Next up, our penultimate first round match. We'll see. Sasha Rose going up against William Caesar. I'm afraid it is, Jim. It makes me authorize it every time. Yeah, it's a pain in the arse. Hell yeah, Fox rule. That was a loud one.
Holy shit.
And that sound. Sasha Rose here to bring the thunder. I can't remember who does it, Jim, but I'll ask Liam. Oh, hello, Liam. Liam, who does that cover of I Will Survive? Lots in the STF. Bizarre Ducks Hilariot. Oh, but not the punch. Good God, y'all. Me first in the Gimme Gimme's. I thought it might have been, but because they cover everything. Oh, they've got lots of good covers, Jim. They did a really good cover of the Popeye theme as well. Takedown from Sasha Rose and the heel hook. Like, Jim, they literally do nothing but covers. I think it's like some of the members of NoFX and a couple of other bands, if I remember right. Shoot streaks into the heel hook again. Oh, just got steamrolled there by Cesar. Locks in that single leg Boston Crab. Kind of. Spike Dragon. I know Sasha made a few gears. Floors over the elbows. Oh, she gets to go behind, but again, that power coming into play. Oh, guillotine. Saw him struggling for breath and just went for it. Tries it again. The big man fights his way out, sent into the ropes. Beautiful hip toss takeover. King's throne does not get the job done. Yeah. Oh, he was playing possum. He's still exhausted, but has recovered nicely. Yeah. Takes him back to the center. fights off the attempt at a submission. Oh, guillotine again. Determined, even if it's not going to get a submission, to try and take the breath out of the big man. A smart maneuver. Goes for it again. Fights his way out. Oh, near naked choke this time. But he makes the ropes. Oh, big splash off the top, but too close to the ropes. Yeah, running's for suckers. Oh. Suplex to the floor, good God. She was going for a kendo stick, the horniest of weapons. Try to choke him out on the floor, hurts more because it's on the floor. The whole Stacks logo. Do they have deals? Probably. To be honest, I was just trying to think of what logos can I rip the piss with? Of course, our proud sponsors, we've got PayPal, Gay Burger, Yikes, Jazz Mags, Pirates, French Fries, Boost Juice, and Whole Snacks. Makes the ropes again. Oh God, caught her with the lariat, into the side headlock. Yeah, Pirates, it's physical fitness for freebooters. Oh God, huge lariat there. Oh, a moonsault! I can't remember what gig it was, but I came up with the Jazz Mags one. Me and Joanna were at a gig at the Glasgow Barrowlands. Very, not the biggest venue in Glasgow, but like the most well-liked. Oh, Ides of Smarts, lousy Smarts weather. I don't know, I just did it as a piss-takey IcoPro gin. So like, we're at the barras, in the queue. And there's like a, basically like a porno shop right across the road from it. And I looked at that, and I had just been thinking about like the sponsors and stuff. And I was like, oh, I bet they sell Jazz Mags. And I actually shouted in the middle of the queue, like, I've got it! Jazz Mags! And, you know. Hell of a match we're seeing right here. Send Cesaro into the ropes, they're both exhausted. Fujiwara armbar! STF. Oh. Hooks in the ankle lock. Cesaro makes the ropes. You can see him scrambling there. And Sasha Rose really starting to come into her element. Nearly got it. Blocks that spinning backhand. He is exhausted. She sends him into the ropes. Lariat. Duke's barrel cheese. Nice. Oh, guillotine again. But he makes the ropes. And you see how much she's been taken out of him. How slowly he's moving. And he's taking this moment to get a bit of respite. I mean, like most sketch shows, Spike Dragon, it is kind of hit and miss, but the bits that are good are really good. like the Butterfield bits are the best. That and toilet gun and kitchen gun and toilet grenade. Bang! 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 Oh, good grief! Just unleashing on his face there. But it seems to have woken him up. She sends him into the ropes with the lariat. But now she's exhausted. Whereas Cesaro seems to have been coming into almost like a second wind. She gets the STF though! But he makes the ropes. It's the toilet grenade that I like the best. This is like the cover in the ears. Bang! Oh, it takes him into the turnbuckle. Again, going to the midsection, trying to drive the wind out of him. Cross-arm breaker locked in. I like the guy who made the bite. I don't know what bite grenade is, but I like the sound of it. Oh, headbutt, cover. And now they're trading. They're trading Maggle. Big boot. Big left hand there from Sasha. Locks in the ankle lock. Oh. Flattens her there. Knee off the go behind. Oh, crossway stricken wing locked in. Oh yeah, I've got McStrong fuck. Cesaro gets the win! So our second round so far has Buff Catwell, Destroyer, Cara De Pato, Luna Rose, Lulu Jambo, Rabbit, Sam King, Jarif Harper, Paige B, Big Chef, Forever Craig, Kingpin Jim, Dragon Spike, William Cesar. And now we'll find out who the last person to be joining them is. As it will be Amelia Duncan. Yes, once again, just for anyone who missed it, our new women's promotion, Women's Action Pro, WAP, will be debuting soon. Going up against El Tigre. Jeremy, welcome. Thank you everyone for joining us. We'll be doing a bit more like silly fun after this last first round match as well. Just the usual by request stuff. the buy request shoot fights that have become a staple of these streams. As yes, for the final section, it becomes Super Pro Wrestle Buried. Thank me. I'm doing well, Jeremy. How's yourself? You doing good? Beautiful DDT there. Amelia Duncan, another relative newcomer who has looked highly impressive so far. Locks in a claw hold, a move that Tigre himself likes to utilise. Spear! A reminder that we're sponsored by Gay Burger, home of the Gay Burger. What would you like between your buns today? A beautiful moonsault, but too close to the ropes for the pinfall attempt. Oh no, Battle Clash is down. Tigre, you fool! Missed with that spinning knee. Tigre was just too far away. Oh god, what is she setting up for here? Charges in with the knee. I mean, Liam, they did let me away with the gay community insignia. And I don't see the PayPal one being a problem. But yeah, I'll send you them if you want. Figure four locked in. Tigre with the combo. Not unlike the combo that you can get at Gate Burger. Cat Labash bust open. Recently retired, of course, from in-ring competition, now an official with us. Beautiful swinging neck breaker from Tigre. Follows it with a Rana. And a sling blade. I love that, Craig. I love it. The lettuce, guacamole, bacon, tomato, quarter pounder. Amelia Duncan with the win. So our second round is filled out. Oh shit, I'm sorry to hear that, Jeremy. Hope you're doing okay, mate.